first off, does anyone have any questions at all on stuff that was taught earlier? Anything you want to see? No? You guys are very quiet. It's creeping me out. Okay, so I guess I'll just show some bottom. I think bottom is equally as important, probably more important than top even, because I feel like it should be a 3-point every match. Once in a blue moon in your career should you really be held down and rode out for 2 minutes straight. I can remember from my college experience, I maybe one or two matches my whole career that I got ridden for 2 minutes. And so you really gotta, there should be a 3-point every match. You should be so confident on anybody that you just do this automatically, right? When the ref asks you what you want, either defer or you're going down. So one thing that I do, so whatever he's good at, it doesn't matter. If he's good at tilts, if I know he's good at legs, cradles, I do the same exact thing off of the whistle. And if my goal is to not let him basically have what he wants. So if I can beat him there, that's my goal. Most of the time I get out right away. So just a few simple things, but people mess up. They start like, people will like stand up like this, two hands and get planted on their face, and then start getting tilted. So I'm not really worried about that. All I'm concerned about is kind of beating him off the whistle. So right off the start, he's given my waist and he's given my elbow. Right? He's not underneath this arm yet. So what I'm gonna do, as soon as the whistle blows, my elbow goes to my side and it stays there. Right? My palm is up, like I'm begging for change, right? For some change, right? That's kind of what I'm doing. If my palm is down, he can grab my wrist, right? And then I start getting tilted and stuff. So off the whistle, the elbow he's on, palm goes up, and I'm kind of begging for change right here. My other hand goes to his fingers. Gets his fingers to the outside, right? Gets those things away. I'm not really concerned about keeping my head up. I'll even go straight to my head so he can't chop me. So quite often this guy's gonna chop right off the whistle, right? My head goes down, my palm's out, I get his fingers. Don't grab his wrist. If you grab his wrist, he can still grab. Get those fingers, squash them up a little bit. Don't grab just one, bend it out if you mess up. Okay, so don't do that. Grab all four. Right here, now I can stand up one on one. See how I get away. But don't be in a hurry to stand up either. Okay, so get your seal right off the whistle. Hands up, get his fingers. I'll go right to my head even. And this looks lazy, but I'm not letting him back inside. So he's gonna try to chop or something. Top guy, try to chop him a little bit. Yeah, exactly. All right, I'm just going with him. I'm keeping the seal, keeping his hand to the outside. And I can stand up when I want now. I'm even in a really bad position right now. My butt's back, my head's down. What can he do? He can't hold on, right? He's not underneath this arm. And I got his fingers to the outside. Cut away what I want. Obviously, you want to be in good position, but I'm just showing. You don't got to be in great position if you're doing this stuff correctly. So, one more time. It's pretty easy. Top guy, give him a little feel, too. Give him a little chop, right? So I got to go to my head, right? Adult, I'm getting planted. Ready to go. Doesn't feel good. Nope. So get his fingers, hand that's on the belly button, get those away from you. Get them far away so he can't grab you. Palms up, stand up when you want. Seal off, get away. From there, we'll work on getting out of legs too, a little later. Maybe it's just as important. Stick with me. I know it's not that exciting stuff, but very important. So go do it, go.